celebrating many things. And we celebrate, I think, today, the fact that we all live in, and Anne and Christina and Annalak and I have the honour of representing in the Parliament, the most multiculturally successful country in the world. Only Canada can rival Australia for our record of success. And we here, all of us, live in the most successful multicultural community in the most successful multicultural country in the world. And again, it is our honour to represent you in the Federal Parliament. Now, there are some special thrills which go with being a Member of Parliament in this area. Every Member of Parliament in Australia has a very special thrill. All of us, right across Australia. But some of us are luckier than others. We get to represent you, live and celebrate your cultures that you have brought to our country and enriched our country. We get to live that every day, officially, unofficially, at ceremonies, walking down the street, when our families see each other. We get to represent your passion for human rights here and in the home countries, and we will continue to argue and to fight for the human rights of those who are not here living with us in Australia. These are some of the special thrills which go with being a member for the areas of southwestern Sydney. It has frustrations too. Sometimes we're frustrated that we're not making more progress in human rights, that we keep arguing and putting petitions and fighting, and yet so many people live under oppressive regimes, and it means that we're not very welcome in some countries. I'd love to visit Cambodia and Laos, but I don't think I'd be made very welcome by current regimes. But maybe one day you can give me tips on where to go and what to see when we can visit free Cambodia, Laos in particular. So these are the pleasures and honours of representing you in our multicultural country. And you're celebrating, I think, that same multiculturalism today and committing all of us to continuing to live those values. And that is something we all need to do to remind ourselves of what a beautiful, successful society we have and live in and represent. And that is the honour of Anne and myself and Christina. And I simply end by saying, I very much hope, and I'm very sure, that Christina and I will be sitting around a cabinet room shortly, where we can represent you at the most senior levels of the Australian government. We represent you in the Federal Parliament. It will be our honour to represent you in the Federal Government, in the cabinet, where both Christina and I would sit at the most senior levels. And she would bring the same passion and dedication and commitment that she has brought to her public life for many years in New South Wales, for the Federal Cabinet, and as your representative here in Fowler. So, thank you so much for the invitation to be with you. It's always a pleasure to come. Last time I was here, in this building, was a stressful time. It was at the absolute worst moment of the pandemic in our area. Parliament was sitting, I didn't go. Our place was here, helping each other. I don't mind telling you, it was stressful for all of us. It was stressful for me, worried about the community. I knew that there was a vaccination hub here. And I've got to tell you, when I drove up and I saw the long lines waiting to be vaccinated, I saw the community leaders encouraging people in, I saw the police and the military here working cooperatively with you, my heart lifted and I thought we're going to be okay. Because this is our community coming together so spectacularly well. You leading the community so spectacularly well. So that is what we're all celebrating today. And it's right that we remind ourselves, sometimes we can take it for granted, that we have to continue to work to be the most successful multicultural country in the world, the most successful multicultural community in the world. And we are very honoured that you've asked us to help you in our own small way launch this initiative today, and I congratulate you all for it. It is wonderful to be part of it, to celebrate. Thong San, happy birthday. It's my daughter's birthday today too. She's 17, not 89. It's a very special day, and it's particularly wonderful that we can all join you today. Thank you so much.
We were too excited to sing and we forgot our job. I'll just say a few words in the hour before we proceed to the next speaker. Khoapai, Tiva Mata, Baba, Tinte, Tiva, Tin, and Tan, Chris Owen, Bolton, Sung Sung Hau, Tiva, Pin Pung Jai, Tiva Day Yu, Ben Put Ke, Tang Na, Sung Sung, and Lai Sung Sung Pao, PUK, Ni, Pung Pung Jai, Tiva Pin Pin Put Ke, Tang Na, Hau,
ពួកយើងទាំងអស់គ្នាដែលបានរួមរងចំពោះគំនិតប្រួយផ្ដើមចំពោះការរួមរងរវាងសហគមន៍លាវកម្ពុជាក្រោមនិងខ្មែរទាំងអស់គ្នាហើយតំណាងរាស្ត្រយើងទាំងពីរនៅថ្នាក់ខ្ពស់សហព័ន្ធនិងនាំយកនៅសេចក្តីខ្វល់ខ្វាយនិងការព្រួយបារម្ភរបស់យើងដែលមានតាក់ទងទៅនឹងសិទ្ធិមនុស្ស ដែលមានតាក់ទងទៅនឹងការគៀបសង្កត់ផ្សេងៗដើម្បីយកទៅពិភាក្សាដើម្បីរកដំណោះស្រាយហើយជួយយើងខ្ញុំទាំងអស់គ្នាដើម្បីជាសំឡេងរបស់ជនដែលគ្នាមិនមានសំឡេង
Thank you, Penny. Our next speaker doesn't need much introductions. We've already given lots of introductions, but she will be a very familiar face shortly in our area. I'd like to welcome Senator Honourable Christina Keneally, candidate for Fowler and Deputy Leader of the Opposition in the Senate, to come to the podium and give a few words. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much for that kind welcome. An absolute delight to be here today. I feel I should begin by saying good afternoon to my fellow Australians. It's lovely to share today with you this joint initiative. Venerable monks, thank you for your blessing. I felt peace as you prayed with us. I'd also like to thank the leaders of the various communities who have brought us here together for this remarkable joint initiative, the launch of the Memorandum of Understanding between the Laos, the Cambodian, and the Khmer Krom communities. It is absolute delight and a remarkable banner there. Thank you. Suwate, of course, with his indefatigable energy, has brought us together here today alongside Mrs. Pinkham Similalong. Lovely to meet you here today. And many of the special guests, but may I also thank Bountum for his hospitality in having us here. You know, as I think about today that you're making a pledge amongst various communities in southwestern Sydney to work together to promote Australian values, and I'm just bringing up something here, I thought about the Australian Citizenship Pledge. And as Shadow Minister for Immigration and Citizenship, I think about this a fair bit. As a migrant myself who took the pledge some 20 years ago, and I imagine many of you in the room have also had the experience of taking that pledge. And I thought about the fact that you're really committing yourself to the thing that we all commit ourselves to as citizens of this country. And the citizenship pledge, which says we pledge our loyalty to Australia and its people, whose democratic beliefs we share, whose rights we and liberties we respect, and whose laws we obey. And I love that pledge because I think it encapsulates everything about Australian values. You know, so there are values we have, aren't there, that we understand, a fair go for all, that we are a successful multicultural country where we respect one another, that we uphold the rule of law, that we have freedom of association, we have freedom of religion, we have freedom of speech. But all of that is so neatly captured by that citizenship pledge. And I think in many ways what you're doing here today is not just committing yourselves to work to uphold Australian values. You're really showing southwestern Sydney and indeed all of Australia what it is to truly live the pledge of citizenship. So thank you for that. Thank you. If I can be very brief and say, as the Shadow Minister for Home Affairs, who I hope to join with my friend Chris to sit around that cabinet table shortly, two challenges play on my mind, and I hope you will be my partners and help me address them. One is the issue of foreign interference. It is real. You know that. I think that we have a job to do to help the broader Australian community understand what foreign interference is, how it operates, and what we can do to keep ourselves safe. Because it operates on governments, it operates on businesses, it operates on social media, and it operates in the lives of individual people. And it is a challenge we face. And the fact that you're coming together to promote social cohesion and stand up for Australian values, and I hope with your local member, as the Minister for Home Affairs, we will be great partners in this work. The other is the rise of right-wing extremism. A change in our political community, the growth of a racist movement that seeks to undermine our Australian values, that seeks to break down our democracy, that seeks to tear apart the pledge we make to one another as citizens. This is a challenge that our national security agencies tell us is a growing terrorist threat. And again, we only counter that threat by coming together as a community. These threats, they tear at the fabric of our society, but they have not torn us apart. Because those values we share, and those values that you are building here today, help keep us safe. So thank you for that. I also want to say I'm incredibly impressed by the reach of the community's political engagement that you have here today, Anne Stanley, the member for Werriwa, Anne Alexia Devong, the member for Macquarie Fields, Chris Bowen, the soon-to-be, the member for McMahon, and I hope soon-to-be minister in an Albanese Labor government. It shows the maturity of your advocacy, of your understanding and appreciation for democracy, and your understanding how we make change happen. Because we, sitting there in Canberra, can't do it alone. We have to do as Chris did, that powerful story you told there, Chris, about working with the community here in this hall to make sure people get vaccinated. That's where the real work of democracy happens. Yes, the question time and the debates and the votes are important, but the real work of a democracy happens what we're doing today. And you have shown your commitments to that democracy. So I thank my fellow parliamentarians and friends for being here today. I thank all of you for your passion for Australia, your passion as Australians, and I look forward to working with you
to promote Australian values and social cohesion. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Senator Kennelly. And like Chris Bowen, member of McMahon, Ms. Anne Stanley has spoken on a number of occasions regarding the situation of Cambodian community here, particularly the foreign interference and human rights situation in Cambodia. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. Anne Stanley, a member of Veriva, also Opposition Whip.
Thank you all so much, and I'd like to begin today by acknowledging the lands of the First Nations people that we meet today. I acknowledge their custodianship for at least 60,000 years, acknowledge elders past, present and emerging, and any elders that join us today. I acknowledge this was, is and always will be Aboriginal land. And I join with my colleagues in hoping that by the end of this year, an Albanese government will make sure that they are recognised. Because until we recognise our First People, I don't think that all of our communities can truly be whole. I obviously acknowledge my parliamentary colleagues, Chris Bowen, Christina Keneally and Analak Chanthavon, all the leaders from the Lao community, and I also thank the venerable monks for their blessing. I agree with Christina. It is amazing, a part of our job. Christina and I were lucky enough on Thursday night to see the rector at Liverpool inducted. And to be, the best part of my job is to be in communities like this, in halls like this, where everybody has a common purpose, they care so much about each other, and they want to bring our community and everybody forward together. No one standing up, no one trying to tear us down. So the best part of our job, I think, is being invited to represent you, but to be so well welcomed. So thank you very much. So much of the rest of what I've said, Christina and Chris have already touched on, but I am really moved to represent such a diverse community with more than half of our citizens born overseas. The way that you bring the best part of your countries, your religions to us, and they become part of what Australia has now become, is just amazing. We are a harmonious and respectful community. And what we saw in the last 2 years during the pandemic is so many volunteers from so many different nations helping each other, not because they're one of them, because they are one of us. So the Lao and the Khmer community helping the Muslim community, the Mandaeans, anybody else, the Serbian community, anyone who needed a hand during the last 2 years, our volunteers have made sure that they were fed, that they were looked after, and if they had to isolate, somebody spoke to them and made sure they were okay. So thank you to all of you who've done that, who've stepped up, because unfortunately our current governments in so many ways have let us down without proper translations and without proper understanding of exactly what happens in the Southwest Sydney and how fantastic our community is, how law-abiding, and how if you ask us to do something, we are more than happy to do what is necessary to keep each and every one of us safe, whatever country they called home and whatever we do here. That's why initiatives like this, I think, are not just important for our communities individually here, but it does send a message to the rest of Sydney and Australia about how wonderful this place is that we call home. Thank you so much for the invitation today.
Our next speaker is Mr. Analak Chantivong, member for Macquarie Fields in our New South Wales Parliament. I am proud and pleased to claim Analak to be one of our own, our very first Lao Member of Parliament. And we are proud to have you today to say a few words. I'd like to welcome you to the podium.
Thank you very much, Serena Kopjanai, Ms. Serena. แค่คู่มิเกียรติท่านหญิงทั้งสายพ่อแม่พี่น้องทุกคนทั้งหลายน้อยคู่สุดดีใจเลยมิเกียรติหลายที่ได้มีโอกาสและร่วมงานสังคมของเขมรและสมุนของลาวด้วยกันมันเป็นหลายปีเลยนะครับผ่านมาใน 2-3 ปีนี้เขาก็มีโอกาสที่จะมาร่วมงานน้อยมีความหวังว่าอีกต่อหน้าต่อไปมันจะสังคมของเราที่จะขึ้นมาอีกเพราะว่าพญาลิมที่ผ่านไป และสุดท้ายขอขอบใจอันคุณสวัสดีและสังคมที่ได้ร่วมงานส่งเสียเวลาที่ร่วมงานแค่เห็นขึ้นมาทุกคนที่ไหนนะ Special guests, my parliamentary colleagues, Anne, Chris and Christina, distinguished guests, thank you very much for inviting me here today to join with you what is such an important community and such a very important initiative to promote the very things we hold dear: social cohesion, Australian values, our democracy, and of course to defend the things that are so important to us as a nation and as individuals. Whilst I'm the member for Macquarie Fields, and this is not in my electorate, being in this hall and being in this place means so much to me. It is a place where I, as a young boy, and I continue to say as a young man, as a father of two, have come here on many occasions with my family to socialise with people who we hold dear, and of course as a place to worship, and as a gathering where anyone is welcome regardless of their faith, of their cultural background, and where they live. So this place certainly holds a very special meaning to me. Today, in promoting the social cohesion and the Australian Values Initiative, there is, all of us can talk about how, what a wonderful place Australia is, and what a successful multicultural nation we are. And this is actually backed up by evidence. So it's not just Chris, Christina, and I saying it, or everybody saying it. This is actually backed up by evidence. The Scandinavian Social Cohesion Index, each and every year, rates Australia as a wonderful place for multicultural, which is inclusive, diverse, and respects those from every part of the globe. Our success, however, is not a natural course of events, or it's actually not by accident. It is the work of everybody in this room and everybody in our communities showing mutual respect to each other, celebrating our cultural diversity, and promoting inclusivity and opportunity. These are the values that I hold dear as a Labor MP, and I know these are the values my fellow Labor MPs hold so dearly, and I think we are so privileged to have Christina and Chris and Anne to represent all of us in the federal parliament. Christina, of course, will be the candidate for Fowler, and I know she, with her experience and her ability, will be such a strong and powerful voice for people in our community. And with our support, we'd like to see her and Chris, of course, at the cabinet table defending all the things that we hold dear. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for inviting me here today. It is so good to be back in normal times as we come to celebrate the things we hold dear, community and the country we all love and the contributions we all want to make to ensure that everybody in our country who is here and who will be here can live a better life. Thank you very much. Kop tai anai.
It's not often we have a parliamentarian who comes up and speaks a different language first. So thank you, Analak, for your words in Lao. I'd just like to do a quick summary in Lao as well for our community of the speeches of Christina and Analak. Senator Christina Keneally. เพิ่นภาคภูมิใจหลายที่ได้ถึงเชิญมางานนี้ได้เห็นสมสนเฮาเข้ากันได้ดีเพราะว่าสําหรับเราอันการเข้าโฮมกันต้อนโฮมกันเป็นวิธีนึงที่ว่าเฮาฮู้อัพไซด์สิทธิมนุษย์ของเฮาฮู้ว่าประชาธิปไตยอยู่ในประเทศนี้แม่นแม่นอย่างแล้วก็ฮู้มาโฮมกันเพื่อป้องกัน ภทนี้และพยายามมีคือเขามาเมื่อในนี้แหละมาพร้อมมาส่งเสริม Australian values คืออันของมิตรของออสเตรเลียพร้อมด้วยเราก็เฝ้าว่าเรากับคริสจะพยายามที่สุดตอนเวลาข้าเจ้าหวังว่าจะได้ไปเป็นรัฐบาลที่ปกครองในเวลาใหม่ๆนี้ที่จะมาซอยสังคมเราเขาเรื่องสังคมเราเขานำรัฐบาลกลางแอนสแตนลีย์ก็คือการเราได้ย่อมยอว่าเขาเป็นชุมชนที่ว่าเขาทุ่มพบกันและซอยเหลือกันได้ดียกตัวอย่างตอนเวลาเป็นโควิดช่วงโควิดเขาได้ซอยสวนกันอันอยู่บนได้ว่าสงสารสงเขาได้เขาก็พยายามซอยเหลือกันตอนช่วงโควิดอันนี้ก็อันนึงที่ว่าเขาพยายามทุ่มพบกันและเราภูมิใจที่ว่าได้เป็นผู้แทนต่างหน้าชุมชนของเขาสุดท้ายคืออนุรักษ์เราว่าอันเราดีใจที่ว่ามันต้องพร้อมกันเพื่อปกป้องสิทธิมนุษย์ความเป็นธรรมของอยู่ประเทศนี้เพราะฉะนั้นเราก็ดีใจที่ว่าได้กลับขึ้นมาสถานที่นี้ที่เราได้เคยมาตั้งแต่น้อยแล้วก็ยังบ่ลืม
พิมพ์กรณ์สมสังขัยบันเทิงปีสันตระกถาระบาลูChris Bowen, Nesrei Christina Kennelly, and Tumnangri and Stanley from Tiang Lok Anonlep. Young Tiang Akhnea Kaban Lu Sadap Ban Chichibat Loa Tha Ah Lok Rai Chia Samai Chit Prisipia Nang Tumnangri. How you know Pnei Khang Parak Ratatibal. Nang Niniti Khanong Ka Tumnang Aoi Puk Yung Tiang Akhnea Rai Chia Samai Chit Nui Khanong Mundur Chanao Kaba Lo.គឺចេញមុខដើម្បីជួយបញ្ចេញសម្លេងនឹងការតស៊ូតបារបស់យើងតែតកតងទៅនឹងផ្នែកសិទ្ធិមនុស្សនិងផ្នែកការទៀមទានៅបញ្ហាខ្លះខ្លះដែលយើងទាំងអស់គ្នាផ្ដល់តម្លៃទៅលើសិទ្ធិសេរីភាពប្រជាធិបតេយ្យនិងជាពិសេសគឺតម្លៃនៃជនជាតិអូស្ត្រាលីដែលយើងឲ្យតម្លៃខ្ពស់បំផុតទៅលើភាពស្មើគ្នាការគោរពគ្នានិងទុកចិត្តរវាងគ្នានិងគ្នានៅក្នុងសង្គមពហុវប្បធម៌នេះសូមអរគុណ
Thank you Khmer for the next item we'd like to invite representatives of the youth of the Cambodian and Khmer Krom youth to come and say a few words we have invited them to come to join us today because they're our next generationWe need to show them and lead by example and model our behaviours. So having them participate today is an honour for us because I think they get to see firsthand what do we really do as parents or elders in our community when we say we're working for the community. So this is an opportunity for them to see firsthand, you know, what is it that we strive for, what is it that we're trying to achieve.So with that, I'd like to invite Hilary Chap, Aidan Egg, and Christina Mao to come forward to say a few words on how they feel as the younger generation growing up in Australia and what it does mean to protect and promote Australian values. If you can come forward. At the same time, I'd also like to acknowledge our young achiever. We've got a Melissa Ng in this audience, is she here? Michelle, this Michelle. Yes, she's first in advanced English HSC last year with a 99.858 pass score. Congratulations, Michelle, for your success, and we hope to be working with you in the future. So I'd like to welcome Hilary. Welcome Hilary to the podium.
Distinguished guests, community leaders, ladies and gentlemen, I am very pleased to be invited to speak as a member of the Youth Network, representing young people born to parents with Cambodian and Khmer Krom heritage on this very important day. Today is important because as a young person born to Cambodian parents, I have rarely seen my parents engage with other communities besides their own to celebrate special events according to Cambodian culture. But today, I am witnessing something that is special and relevant to my generation that is promoting Australian values for the purpose of building a strong social cohesion. Through this engagement and initiative, I got to learn not only about my own culture, but also about the history and background of the indigenous Khmer Krom people, which I hadn't known about until I took part in this engagement. For example, I learned that Aiden has heritage of Khmer Krom, and his grandfather was born in what is now known as South Vietnam. I knew of Laos as a country, but I had not connected with or experienced much of their culture until I participated with Aiden's father and mine. I learned of the similarities in culture and tradition between Laos and Cambodia, and of course that the Khmer Krom people are indigenous Cambodians from the south of Vietnam. Hence, this engagement today is historic as it gives myself and other young people such as Aiden, who are born to Cambodian parents and Khmer Krom parents, to be connected and appreciate the values that all the community leaders have come together to promote today. I am extremely appreciative of the fact that all the elders from the three communities have been working hard to organise this event professionally with a taste of their own culture whilst also incorporating Australian values. For Asian Australian youths in particular, I believe it is important for us to connect with our rich cultural backgrounds through the works of our parents. With the knowledge gained from the experiences that they have lived through, they will help to guide us, as we witness today, ensuring a strong social cohesion amongst all communities. As a young person, I am extremely proud to see that the connections and concerns that our parents have with their homelands are being supported by you all at federal and state levels. I witnessed this gesture by the elders when Aiden and I participated on the 9th of January to witness the official signing ceremony of the Memorandum of Engagement as displayed in the purple banner behind me and as observed by a member of the Myanmar community. The Memorandum of Engagement signifies the common interests that bring together all the communities from Cambodia, Khmer Krom, Myanmar and Laos. Last year, I also met Ms. Senator Christina Keneally at the Cambodian Temple with other Cambodian and Khmer Krom representatives seated with us here today and received a letter from Ms. Anne Stanley after she had spoken in Parliament about Cambodia, and I am very pleased to see them taking part in this event today. In conclusion, today's historic event represents an excellent example of cross-cultural collaborations for the primary focus of practicing and promoting Australian values. With this joint initiative being the first step in our journey of promoting Australian values as young people, we look forward to actively engaging with our parents, their communities, and their initiatives to help strengthen Australian values. Thank you.
Thank you, Hillary. I know if my grandfather were here with us today, he'd be very proud of us, as the youth, for being empowered by our parents to learn more about our culture and to experience it and share it within the context of promoting Australian values. And so I believe that this is our multicultural spirit. I'd like to welcome our young Lao dancers who have been practicing this dance for this event especially. The dance is about young, beautiful girls dancing in the gardens, picking flowers. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, the dancers from the La La Sang dancing school. I'd also like to mention that, you know, with this cross-cultural combination, one of the girls is a Lao and Cambodian heritage, so it was fitting for her to be dancing on this occasion. That's really... they did say to ask me to mention that to apologise for any shortcomings because they haven't been to Lao school for quite a while and haven't practiced, so it was very quick practice before they went on stage. The next item on our programme is some presentation of plaques and the memorandum of understanding. As you heard Hilary say, on the 9th of January, the Lao and Cambodian and Khmer communities came together to sign the Memorandum of Understanding, which you can see behind me on the back of your program. It's our commitment to promote social inclusion and Australian values. I'd like to invite the representatives from the communities to come forward and receive a memorandum. From the Lao community, Mr. Pui Prakason, please come forward. From the Cambodian community, Mr. Nyang Yin. From the Khmer Krom community, Mr. Son Lam. And from the Burmese community, who were our observers on that day, on the 9th of January, Ms. Mon Zin. The representative, can you come forward to the front, please? You say
it. Is it me as well? No.
Okay, Pakasan. I've heard Pakasan. Is the Nyang Yin? Stand at the front there. Mr. Son now.
You can stand at the front. Please stand at the front. Stand at the front. You stand at the front.
And for the honour of presenting the Memorandum of Engagement, I'd like to invite Senator the Honourable Christina Keneally to come forward. If Christina can stand to the side and we'll take a photo of you.
Thank you, Senator Kennelly. The next item would be recognition. Plaque presentation by Ms. Anne Stanley, MP, and Honourable Chris Belvin, MP, to Cambodian and Khmer Krom members for their advocacy effort contributing to human rights work as part of the commemorations of the 30th anniversary of Cambodia Peace Accord in 1991. This event was scheduled to take place in Parliament House in October 2021, but cancelled due to COVID-19. Could I invite the following people from the Khmer Krom community about Vulnerable Pao Savung? Mr. Silvery, and a special plaque is presented to Cambodia Krom Cultural Center. I invite Mrs. Mary Lee. Mrs. Mary Lee, late husband Sang Lee, was the president of the organization, but he sadly passed away. So Mrs. Mary Lee will take that plaque. I would like to invite Mr. Chris Bowen to come to the front and present the plaque to the following volunteer.
Okay.
My apology, I forgot Mrs. Sisama's stray. Serena's mother-in-law, unfortunately, she is on the holiday in Perth. So she has nominated Serena Mum. Her in-law, Mrs. Pinkham Simalawong, who herself an elder of the Lao community and one of the earlier activists promoting Lao community. And we stand in this building thanks to you in part for her contribution. We are honored for her to be here with us and receiving the plaque on behalf of her Cambodian in-law.
Thank you. Please be seated. Kosona. We'd also like to acknowledge people who've assisted Sawate in his many advocacy efforts and for their behind the scenes work. So I'd like to call onto the stage Simon Cobble, Ang Peng, Sarah Nguyen, Pini Un, and Bot Chat to come forward. Yes, and please invite, I'd like to invite Anne to come forward to give out the plaques. These plaques are also in, on the anniversary of the Paris Peace Accords. And it's good to see someone who's non-Asian from another community helping us. Thank you. Session in the program, we thought we'd have a 5-minute break so that people can do have a bit of a rest, a bit of water. Our next item on the program is our question and answer time, getting to know your MPs. While Bot sets up the stage for the MPs, please feel free and to have a quick drink of there have been people around on the floor. I think in the interest of time, we'll have floating microphones. So put your hand up if you want to ask a question, and they will try to answer as much as they can. It's about getting to know MPs. If you want to know about the democratic process, how the government works, what can they act on your behalf, what are the issues you'd like them to raise or think about to help your community? Please start thinking about that question, and then we'll have a short question and answer on stage.
Yeah. I think I'm going to stay down here.
Yeah, I'll
think it's maybe a good idea if we don't have to go up.
You want to go up to help them?
Help what? I don't know. They know what to do.
All right.
No.
I think people are tired and want a quick drink.
We try to make it short as much as we can.
So even if we, what's the time now?
Did you say it's nearly 2?
That's fine, we'll go to quarter. Well, Vodafone is 2:30. Yes. So it doesn't matter if we go to start at 2. If we start at 2, we can make it short. I think people are tired.
Yeah.
So you start at 2 o'clock?
Yep.
If everyone could be back at their seats at 2 p.m., we'd appreciate it, please.
Yeah.